Wildfires also ravaging through Washington state, leaving one person dead. Evacuation efforts are ongoing. The fast-moving wildfire has destroyed nearly 200 structures. Authorities say only 10% of the blaze has been contained.
We have to fight these fires as hard in as many ways that we can. And I'm glad that we have bolstered our firefighting apparatus and operations in the last year. But we have to recognize we need to continue that effort, because the fact of the matter is there's a beast at our door, and that's the beast of climate change. It seems like the whole world is on fire today. Yellowknife, Canada, with over 1,000 fires burning in Canada. Maui with Lahaina burnt to the ground, and now Spokane County, and 35,000 acres in fire today in Washington state.
Over now to wildfire hit Hawaii. Following intense criticisms over the federal government's response, U.S. President Joe Biden will visit Maui Monday to see the destruction caused by the unforgiving wildfires. More on this report.
Oh my gosh, look at the harbor.
As rapidly spreading wildfires left Hawaii's second largest island smoldering, pilot Richie Olsten saw it all from his cockpit.
Hundreds of homes leveled down to the ground. The historic section of the town is destroyed. All the historic buildings, Lahaina used to be the capital of all of Hawaii. Even the boats in the harbor were burned down to the water. They're gone.
What started as a brush fire quickly escalated amid a perfect storm of high winds and dry conditions that scorched the historic town of Lahaina in Maui, burning much of this commercial and cultural hub to the ground. Maui's emergency chief Herman Undaya resigned during the disaster amid criticism for not sounding the emergency sirens typically used to signal tsunami warnings. Undaya defended the decision, saying tsunami warnings drive people inland, and in this case, that meant straight into the fire. His resignation was officially due to health reasons. More than 110 people have died in the fires, a number that is expected to grow in the coming days. The number of people missing remains unclear, but Hawaii first responders recently received reinforcements from the Department of Defense. Members of the U.S. Army and National Guard joined search and rescue teams, and the Federal Emergency Management Agency, or FEMA, says relief efforts have so far been a success.
Right now, the search efforts are 78% complete in Lahaina town, and we continue to have our teams on the ground going through all of the structures that were lost as a result of this fire. But we've also given out already over $8 million to families that have been impacted and registered for assistance with FEMA, and our shelter population is down to just over 40, with over 1,200 people that are people that have been moved into hotels, motels, and other types of short-term rentals.
President Joe Biden and First Lady Jill Biden are scheduled to visit Lahaina Monday. For area residents struggling to get basic needs met, Biden brings a sense of hope that relief will quickly go where it's most needed.
I'm very hopeful that him coming in will help expedite a lot of products coming in, a lot of supplies that aren't able to make it, like the guys are, I found out from guys that are staying at the hotel that if it's not FEMA certified or Red Cross, they're not getting the supplies that are waiting outside their door. So, you know, it's frustrating.
Even amid a global outpouring of donations and support, the Bidens will be visiting a disaster zone marked by the deadliest wildfires in more than a century. Arash Arabasadi, VOA News.
Canada sending its armed forces to British Columbia to help battle wildfires. Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau calls the situation in Northwest Territories extraordinarily serious. And more than 35,000 people are under evacuation orders in Canada as wildfires burn out of control.
The federal government is continuing to step up. We're there with Canadian Armed Forces resources. We're active in coordinating with regional and local governments to make sure people are safe, make sure we're doing everything to protect lives and property. But there's a lot more to do, and we're going to continue to stay focused on that.
This is Canada's worst ever wildfire season, with more than 1,000 active fires burning across the country. California bracing for a highly unusual summer storm. Tropical Storm Hilary is pummeling Mexico on its path to the U.S., where it's expected to cause life-threatening floods. Let's get the latest from ABS-CBN's North America Bureau Chief, TJ Manoko. TJ, what do you have for us? Good morning.
Good morning, Nikki, from gloomy and rainy Los Angeles, where I am right now. But as you mentioned, it's a historic storm system that is currently inside California right now, as Hurricane Hilary, though now downgraded to tropical storm, is making its way through Southern California. Just yesterday, Southern California was shocked to hear of a tropical storm warning in a region that hardly gets any rain. Now, the last time SoCal experienced a tropical storm was in 1939, and that then killed 100 people. Hurricane Hilary was, as of yesterday, packing winds of as high as 120 miles per hour. This time around, the federal and local governments are obviously much better prepared today, as Hilary made landfall in Mexico and inching its way through San Diego. It's now southeast of San Diego and packing winds of up to 60 miles per hour. If you do the math of the hurricane winds compared to what we're used in the Philippines, that's more or less like anywhere between a signal number two and a signal number three. So amidst the slower winds, Hilary could potentially still be a devastating storm to hit in the most recent years. In Arizona, the evacuation orders were given in segments of Lake Mead National Park. They're asking people there to seek higher ground. The governor of Nevada has already declared a state of emergency on Sunday. And even San Diego's Filipino-American Mayor Todd Gloria already declared a state of emergency to be able to act faster when needed. Now, more than 1,000 flights also have been canceled in the affected airports in the region. The general advice, really, Nikki, for people here, stay home, stay indoors, avoid unnecessary travel. There will be pockets and areas prone to flash flooding, and some could be catastrophic. So officials advise people, stay home, wait this out, be prepared to wait the night until Monday morning. And yesterday, we saw news reports of lots of people going to the groceries, to Costco and all that, packing mineral water and canned goods, just being prepared. Who knows, they may be stuck at home for a day or two with power outages and whatnot. But so far, no reports of mass flooding and power outages just yet. But we're still expecting the worst of the storm to hit the area from tonight until early tomorrow morning, Nikki.
Mm-hmm. And TJ, before I let you go, how's the Filipino community getting this news? What's the sentiment there?
Well, so far, the Philippine consulate here in Los Angeles actually gave their warning yesterday. They advised, Filipinos in the area, whether Filipino-Americans or Filipinos traveling here, to heed the advice of local officials to continue to monitor the news, avoid going out to the streets, and avoid non-essential travel. It's interesting because this kind of weather, Filipinos are used to this. So we, back home, we go out and about it, which is signal number one. Signal number two, there's still school, there's still work and all that. So there's that potential of taking things easy and being a little bit overconfident. But again, there are pockets where it could get scarier in the valleys, in the mountainous regions. They're prone to landslides, they're prone to stronger winds, even though it gets milder here near to the water. So they just should really be more wary and stay in touch and see where they are and see what dangers are in their area. But so far, we have no reports of any Filipinos really being affected. But we'll see what happens tomorrow when we gather more information from our officials at the Philippine Consulate.
Yeah, it is unusual for California. Thanks again, TJ. You stay safe and you stay dry. Let's get an update on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Veronica Torres. Veronica, good morning.
Good morning, Ms. Nikki, and to all of our audience. As of now, southwest monsoon is affecting the western sections of southern Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. And we're expecting cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over the Buanga Peninsula, Barm, Sogsaygen, Davao del Sur, and Palawan. Better weather condition is expected over Metro Manila and the rest of the country, where it's partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain showers or thunderstorm. We don't have any gale warning raised over any seaboards of our country, and we're not monitoring any low pressure area or tropical cyclone inside or near the Philippine area of responsibility. And that's the latest from PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center, Veronica Torres.
All right, some good news. Thanks for that update, Veronica.